Good morning, my dear friends, and welcome to morning prayer on this Sunday morning, which is lovely and mild considering it's winter. And it's good to welcome Sister Sue before she goes on her long journey to see Aunt Evelyn and pray it's a good day. And for those not logged in, you are welcome. We begin by lighting a candle for universal peace and intra-spiritual unity. We thank our Father, Mother, God for this new day, a new dawn, the first day of the rest of our life. And we offer our morning prayer in union with all prayer being offered by all faiths and none for the glory of God, for the salvation of souls, for peace and unity in the world, and for God's blessing on our community and all our members past and present. And on our two live stream channels, we give thanks. Our Sunday morning prologue reads, "We enter the eternal and infinite garden with reverence to the heavenly Father, Mother, God, the earthly Mother, and all the great masters, and reverence to the holy, pure, and saving teaching, and reverence to the brotherhood and sisterhood of the elect. Sunday morning, we commune with the angel of earth, saying, Angel of earth, enter my generative organs and regenerate my whole body. As you say this, you contemplate the generating soil and the growing grass, feeling the currents of the angel of earth, transforming his sexual energy into regenerative forces. We also welcome our dear sister Heather, whom we haven't seen for some time, and pray that she's well. So let us begin the traditional office of Lourdes that is said in all monastic houses around the Christian world. O God, come to my aid. O Lord, make haste and help me. Glory be to the Father, Mother, God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. And our hymn this morning, I bind unto myself today the strong name of the Trinity, the three in one and one in three, by invocation of the same. And I've just lost my page, forgive me. Ah, here we go. There we go. The three in one and one in three. I bind unto myself today the power of God to hold and lead, his eye to watch, his might to stay, his ear to hearken to my need, the wisdom of my God to teach, his hand to guide, his shield to ward, the word of God to give me speech, his heavenly host to be my God. I bind unto myself the name, the strong name of the Trinity, by invocation of the same, the three in one and one in three, of whom all nature hath creation, eternal Father, Mother, Spirit, Word. Praise to the Lord of my salvation. Salvation is of Christ the Lord. Let us just reflect on those beautiful words. Be still now. Our first antiphon this morning: Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Alleluia. And now we read Psalm 117. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his love endures forever. Let the sons of Israel say, His love endures forever. Let the sons of Aaron say, His love endures forever. Let those who fear the Lord say, His love endures forever. I called to the Lord in my distress. He answered and freed me. The Lord is at my side. I do not fear. What can man do against me? The Lord is at my side as my helper. I shall look down on my foes. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in men. It is better to take refuge in the Lord than to trust in princes. The nations all encompassed me. In the Lord's name, I crushed them. They compassed me about like bees. They blazed like a fire among thorns. In the Lord's name, I crushed them. I was hard pressed and was falling, but the Lord came to help me. The Lord is my strength and my song. He is my Savior. There are shouts of joy and victory in the tents of the just. The Lord's right hand has triumphed. His right hand has raised me. The Lord's right hand has triumphed. I shall not die, I shall live and recount his deeds. I was punished by the Lord, but not doomed to die. Open to me the gates of holiness. I will enter and give thanks. This is the Lord's own gate, where the just may enter. I will thank you, for you have answered. You are my Savior. The stone which the builders rejected has become the cornerstone. This is the work of the Lord, a marvel in our eyes. We rejoice and we are glad. O Lord, grant salvation. O Lord, grant success. Blessed in the name of the Lord is he who comes. We bless you from the house of the Lord. The Lord God is our light. Go forward in procession with branches, even to the altar. You are my God, and I thank you. My God, I praise you. Give thanks to the Lord, for he is good, for his great love endures forever. Let us pray the Gloria. Glory be to the Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Alleluia. And the second antiphon, let us sing a hymn to our God. Alleluia. And now we have a canticle reading from the prophet Daniel. You are blessed, Lord God of our fathers. To you glory and praise forevermore. Blessed your glorious holy name. To you glory and praise forevermore. You are blessed in the temple of glory. To you glory and praise forevermore. You are blessed who gaze into the depths. To you glory and praise forevermore. You are blessed in the firmament of heaven. To you glory and praise forevermore. You who walk on the wings of the wind, to you glory and praise forevermore. May they bless you, the saints and the angels. To you glory and praise forevermore. From the heavens, the earth and the sea, to you glory and praise forevermore. You are blessed, Lord God of our fathers. To you glory and praise forevermore. And now we pray the Gloria. Glory be to the Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Let us sing a hymn to our God. Alleluia. And the third antiphon, Praise the Lord for his surpassing greatness. Alleluia. And now we read Psalm 150. Praise God in his holy place. Praise him in his mighty heavens. Praise him for his powerful deeds. Praise his surpassing greatness. Oh, praise him with the sound of the trumpet. Praise him with lute and harp. Praise him with timbrel and dance. Praise him with strings and pipes. Oh, praise him with the resounding cymbals. Praise him with clashing of cymbals. Let everything that lives and that breathes give praise to the Lord. Glory be to the Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. Praise the Lord for his surpassing greatness. And we have a beautiful reading now from Scripture from the prophet Ezekiel. I shall pour clean water over you, and you will be cleansed. I shall cleanse you of all your defilement and all your idols. I shall give you a new heart and put my spirit in you. I shall remove the heart of stone from your bodies and give you a heart of flesh instead. I shall put my spirit in you and make you keep my laws and sincerely respect my observances. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. And the short responsory, we give thanks to you, O God, and call upon your name. We give thanks to you, O God, and call upon your name. We recount your wonderful deeds. We give thanks to you, O God, and call upon your name. Glory be to the Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God. We give thanks to you, O God, and call upon your name. And the Benedictus Antiphon for the 33rd Sunday of the church year reads, they will see the Son of Man coming on the clouds of heaven with great power and glory. And now, my dear brothers and sisters, I invite you to join me for the beautiful Benedictus, the Canticle of Zechariah. Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel. He has visited his people and he has redeemed them. He has raised up for us a mighty Savior in the house of David, his servant, as he promised through his prophets from of old, a Savior who would free us from our sin, from the hands of all our enemies. So his love for our Father is revealed and his holy covenant remembered. He swore to Abraham, our father, to grant us that free from fear and safe from the hands of our enemies, we might serve him in holiness and justice all the days of our life in his presence. And as for you, little child, you shall be called a prophet of God the Most High. You shall go before the Lord to prepare his ways before him, to make known to his people their salvation through forgiveness of their sin, and the resurrection of the body, and the loving kindness of the heart of our God, who visits us like the dawn from on high, and he will give light to those who sit in darkness, and those who dwell in the shadow of death. He will guide them to the way of peace. Glory be to the Father, Mother God, to the Lord Jesus Christ, our teacher, to the Holy Spirit of God, as it was in the beginning, is now, and ever shall be, world without end. Amen. And we repeat the antiphon. They will see the Son of Man coming on the clouds of heaven with great power and glory. And now we come to our morning intercessions. And for those of you who have not logged in, you are more than welcome to join us this day. Just sit quietly where you are and allow the Spirit of God touch you with love. And whatever ails you or troubles you, name it, bless it, and release it, and give thanks. Let us thank our Saviour who came into the world that God might be with us. The response, we praise you, O Lord, and we thank you. We welcome you with praise. You are the day star, the first fruits from the dead. Let us rise with you to walk in the light of Easter. Response, we praise you, O Lord, and we thank you. Help us on this day of rest to see goodness in all your creatures. Open our eyes and our hearts to your love in the world. Response, we praise you, O Lord, and we thank you. Lord, we meet around your table as your family. Help us to see that our bitterness is forgotten, our discord is resolved, and our sins are forgiven. Response, we praise you, O Lord, and we thank you. We pray for all Christian and non-Christian families today. May your Spirit deepen their unity in faith and love. Response, we praise you, O Lord, and we thank you. And we prayed this morning for Sister Sue and Paul, who will be making a long journey over to Yorkshire to see their Aunt Evelyn. We pray that that journey is blessed. We pray that Aunt Evelyn is making progress and that all will be well there with the family. We prayed this morning for all gathered here. And we ask Almighty God to bless you and provide for you. We pray for all religious leaders, especially His Holiness the Dalai Lama, our Holy Father Francis, and Her Majesty Queen Elizabeth, head of the Church of England. But we pray for all religious leaders. And we pray for the world's leaders at the G8 summit. We pray that integrity and truth will prevail, and that Mr. Putin, President Putin of Russia, who's coming under a lot of criticism for the way he's handling the problem with Ukraine, that our European leaders will make it clear to him that it is not lawful and just what he's doing. But we pray for those who are corrupt. We pray for the bankers, for those who've deceived the ordinary person on the street and left many penniless and homeless. We pray that the arm of God's justice will bring them to task, and that all will live by a common code, your code, O Lord, a code of integrity, a code of love, a code of justice and right doing. I pray today for all those who are living with Ebola and those who care for them. And I also pray for Band Aid, that it will be a great success and raise lots of money, not just from within our country, but around the world, to send a positive message to them that we care. But we give thanks for this country. We're small, but we're a country of love, like Children in Need, that raised over £31 million to support children who are disabled and in need and for their families. I thank you, God, for the generosity and the love within this small land. Thank you, God. For all our needs this day, we say thank you. We thank you for our amazing presenters, for Tony and Barbara last night and Doves for Peace. We thank you, Lord, that there wasn't one interruption or blip. We thank you for his music, his singing, and for Barbara's wonderful sharing and poetry on the life of Bridget of Ireland. Beautiful. And tonight we pray for Kedar and Elspeth and their contribution on Livestream, for all our needs, for all that God has given to us, the air that we breathe, the food that we eat, the clothes that we wear, the water that we drink. We say thank you, Father, Mother, God. Now bless your whole family, and we pray especially for your children who are hurting in mind, body, and spirit today, for they are our brother and sister. Amen. And now we come to the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, Mother, God, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our trespasses, we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not astray, but deliver us from the forces of darkness, the forces of evil that seek to alienate us from a loving God. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. And our prayer this morning: Lord our God, give us grace to serve you always with joy, because our full and lasting happiness is to make of our lives a constant service to the author of all that is good. We make our prayer through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you and the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. And that brings us to the end of morning prayer for this beautiful Sunday morning. But before we go, we share with you a Celtic blessing. The blessings of heaven, the blessings of earth, the blessings of sea and sky, on those we love this day, and on every human family, the gift of heaven, the gifts of earth, the gifts of sea and sky. Namaste. Shalom inshallah pax et bonum. Om shanti. Solo di caritas. Salam alaikum. And may the peace of your God, Goddess, reawaken in you this day the I Am presence of love. Have a beautiful day, dear friends. And as we blow out our candles, we blow peace to one another. And now we blow peace, love, and joy to the world. Amen. God bless you.